Good afternoon students, today we are going to start new chapter called Natural Calamities. Natural calamities are disasters caused by natural forces. Types of natural calamities include hurricane, earthquake, tsunamis. Often these calamities are connected such that one sets off another, as with earthquakes and tsunamis. Natural calamities are differentiated from human-made calamities such as industrial accidents. Natural calamities are disasters caused by natural forces. Types of natural calamities include hurricanes, earthquakes, tsunamis. Often these calamities are connected such that one sets off another, as with earthquakes and tsunamis. Natural calamities are differentiated from human-made calamities such as industrial accidents. Earthquake is a terrible kind of natural calamity. Where earthquake occurs, the earth shakes. If earth shakes violently, the result is disaster. Man may escape other kinds of calamity, but if earthquakes occurs, there is no way out. The interior of the cause of the earthquake. The interior of the earth is full of hot liquid. This liquid has been cooling at its surface. Its surface cools and contracts. Upon it is drawn downwards. The earth upon it cracks in this process. When the water from a sea passes down through these cracks and touches the hot liquid, it gives rise to a mass of steam. When the steam expands and dashes to come out, the earth is violently shaken. Thus happens earthquake. The steam under the earth finds a easy way out through a volcano. So, the land which is full of volcano is frequently invested by earthquakes. The interior of earth is full of hot liquid. This liquid has been cooling at its surface. When its surface cools and contracts, earth upon it is drawn downward. The earth upon it cracks in this process. When water from the sea passes through this crack and touches hot liquid, it gives rise to a mass of steam. When the steam expands and dashes to come out, the earth is violently shaken. Thus happens the earthquake. The steam through this volcanic explosion come out fire, smoke, steam and liquid substance called lava. When earthquake happens, the earth comes out under a terrible convulsion. Huge castles and buildings are violently shaken. They break down, beating a lot of inmates inside them. A lot of forest trees shake violently and get uprooted. Things are tossed. People cannot stand upright. They cannot walk. They cannot run. They cannot lie down. They too are tossed like the movable. Water in ponds and rivers is thrown upwards. Sometimes they rush off their beds and flow elsewhere. The water in the lakes and rivers get highly upset. Fire tosses off heavens and it burns the settlements. Rivers dry up and mountains sink down. Earthquake makes heavy loss of life and property. Crops are ruined. Stones are destroyed. Famine breaks out. Within few minutes, beautiful cities full of palatial buildings lie waste like a war-ravaged country. The men who were few minutes back boasting of their wealth and pride are found about moving with begging bowls in their hands. Earthquakes are not new to the world. It is a common thing in many parts of the earth. Japan is a constant victim of earthquakes, so the Japanese make house of paper boards. India too is not altogether free of this natural calamity, but in India it is very few and far. In 1993, Maharashtra had faced a terrible shock from a devastating earthquake, and the Latur were completely damaged. Earthquake cannot be prevented. They catch up by surprise. Hence, let us wait for a scientific development that may find remedy to this terrible upsurge. Seismograph is an instrument used to detect an earthquake. People who study earthquakes are called seismographs. Next, floods. Flood is caused by three factors: cloud burst, monsoon depression and tropical cycle. Often deforestation and soil erosion are causing floods. India depends upon rain on both the monsoon, southwestern and northeastern. The southwest monsoon starts in May and continues up to the end of the September. The northeast monsoon starts in November and continues up to the right of the middle January. Heavy rain caused an account of three seasons referred to result in overflow of rivers. The major rivers that cause floods in India are Ganges and its tributaries, Brahmaputra and Godavari. The problem has become severe now on account of deforestation and depositing of soil in the beds. When heavy rains fall in catchment areas, they lead to soil erosion and fertile alluvial soil is washed off and deposited in the river beds. It helps some countries. For example, deposit left by Nile has helped Egypt. But is not so in case of rivers either in India and China. When flood occurs, they inundate low-lying areas by the sides of the rivers and cause huge loss of life of crops and other properties. Cloudburst means highly concentrated rainfall in a particular area which is far above the normal. This usually happens in places like Rajasthan and India. Moreover, depressions occur both in Bay of Bengal and Arabian Sea. They are more frequent in the Bay of Bengal. At least 20 depressions occur every year between May and September in different parts of the Bay of Bengal. These depressions result in heavy rains in coastal areas of Andhra Pradesh, Odisha, Bengal, Bihar and Uttar Pradesh. The depression caused in the Arabian Sea helps rains in Gujarat, Rajasthan and South Himalayan parts. However, with the construction of dams on almost all rivers, intensity of floods has been checked. The other rivers which are overflowing are now like to be harnessed soon. Flood may not be a serious problem to us. The heavy deforestation is causing alarm. It has to be checked. Dams and canals linking the rivers in contiguous city, for example, a canal linking Ganges and Kaveri would solve the problem. The cyclones are more dangerous as they are combined with high speed winds. A cyclonic storm with the forming of an eye may take any direction. The high speed winds which start a cyclone cause more damage than the accompanying floods. The Odisha super cyclone of 1991, one of the worst cyclones to hit India. It claimed more than 10,000 lives and shattered the lives of millions. Those who survived the cyclone felt that the dead were more fortunate, revealing the intensity of the suffering of the survivors. Tsunami is a Japanese name for harbor waves. Tsunami is a Japanese name for harbor waves. Tsunami is a Japanese name for harbor waves. Generally called tidal waves, but actually tsunami has nothing to do with tides. Tsunami is generated when an ocean floods shift vertically, usually due to an earthquake. When a shift in ocean floor displaces the water above, water body travels as a huge wave to regain equilibrium. Actually, tsunami is a result of sudden rise or fall of a section of Earth's crust. Under the ocean. In the latest tsunami on 26 January 2004 in Indian Ocean, because of an undersea disturbance which was the result of 8.9 magnitude earthquake just off the northern tip of Indonesia's Sumatra Islands. This created havoc in Indonesia, Hong Kong, Sri Lanka and India. It is estimated that more than 1 million people lost their lives and more than this are missing, and the total loss must be hundreds of crores. Droughts are caused on account of scanty rainfall. This happens mostly on account of vagaries of monsoon, which are not under our control. They usually occur in rain shadow areas like Anantapur, Mahabub Nagar in Telangana, Anantapur in Andhra Pradesh, and in some districts of Maharashtra and Rajasthan. They can also be overcome by adopting scientific methods of conservation of soil and by constructing check dams. Level could be raised. This would help us to avoid droughts. ICRISAT, International Crops Research Institute for Semi-Arid Tropics, established at Hyderabad, is extending immense service in this direction. Hence, we can confidently hope that drought no longer may threaten us. Nature has its own ways. We should respect We should respect and safeguard the environment without polluting it, destroying it. Man with all his intelligence is able to safeguard himself against a flood, but is not able to produce, increase or reduce rainfall which causes the flood. Hence, nature still remains our master. A volcano is an opening in the planet's surface which allows hot, molten rock, ash and gases to escape below the surface. The name volcano originates from the name Vulcan, a Roman god of fire in the Roman mythology. Volcanoes are giant safety valves that release the pressure that builds up inside the earth. The Hawaii Islands were formed by 5 volcanoes. Classified by extent of their activity, volcanoes are 4 types. An active volcano is that one erupts regularly. There are about 500 known active volcanoes on earth, not counting those live beneath the sea. A volcanic eruption erupts when the hot rocks and water burst from a volcano. Geysers and springs are actually just volcanoes that throw boiling water high in the air. They are caused by volcanic heat warming trapped underground. The liquid rocks in a volcano called magma, and when it flows out, it is called as lava. Fresh lava has temperature up to 700 degrees or 2200 degrees and glows red hot to white hot as it flows. The most dangerous volcanic eruption is the eruption of Mount St. Helens in Washington. The tallest volcano is Ojos del Salado, a volcano in Chile. The world's largest volcano is the Mauna Loa in Hawaii. Volcanoes are generally concentrated on the edge of continents along the island chain beneath the sea, forming long mountain ranges. A major part of world's active volcano above sea level encircles the Pacific Ocean, forming the Ring of Fire. Volcanoes can have serious effects on the lands and people around them when they erupt. The destruction they leave in their wake accounts for the total annihilation of the surrounding landscape. Around 2 lakh people have lost their life to volcanic eruption in the past 500 years. Buildings are destroyed, people are rendered homeless, people are killed, plant and animals both are destroyed. Poisonous gases that emanate from the volcanoes can cause death and diseases like pneumonia. However, not everything associated with the volcanoes is negative. The crust of the earth exists due to the large volumes of magma that did not erupt but instead cooled below the surface. It results in rich soil, which is good for cultivation. The volcanic ash that blows out of a volcano increases the soil fertility by adding nutrients to the soil. Groundwater heated by magma. Metallic minerals, copper, gold, silver, zinc are mined from magmas found deep. Thank you.